for me, the formative experience was that I was working overseas during a war in the Gaza Strip. And when I was trying to practice, I wasn't able to practice properly because there were no stethoscopes. There was one stethoscope between 10 doctors trying to deal with almost 100 patients. It was my stethoscope that I brought from Canada. So after that, I thought there has to be a better way to deal with this, a way to reduce the cost and maintain the quality. This is the stethoscope that our team worked on engineering. And basically, it consists of three main parts. The first one is this, 3D printed parts. These come off of a 3D printer, like you see behind me. And basically what that does is deposit layers of plastic one by one until it comes up with an intricate shape. These are from a kind of plastic that can be easily recycled and is available anywhere. It's the same kind of plastic that you would use in Lego. So it really is everywhere. The other sort of part is tubes. We picked these tubes because these tubes are available in Coca-Cola machines, and we figured there's Coca-Cola everywhere, so there'll be this tube everywhere. And indeed, we have yet to run into a place that doesn't have this tube. And then the last part, the diaphragm, comes from Duotang covers. So these are the same covers you would have used on your reports when you were in grade school. And we just use a craft punch to punch them open. When we put all of these together, we end up with a stethoscope that looks very much like the traditional stethoscope and behaves very much like the traditional stethoscope. Our product from this research is not the stethoscope. It is how to make the stethoscope and how to make sure that that stethoscope is the best quality imaginable. We used modern techniques to test this stethoscope against the acoustics of other stethoscopes, and we're able to prove that it is just as good in terms of the acoustics, or at the very least, not inferior. Our colleagues love it. They kind of divide in two main categories. In places like the Gaza Strip, this really changes practice fundamentally. And so the feedback, of course, is different. In Canada, doctors say, this is really cool. In the Gaza Strip, people say, wow, this is really essential.